It's 2022, which means programmers have fully fledged out applications like VS Code, Atom, and a billion others that they can use when they're writing code. Pretty much every developer has at one point used Vim, which is a terminal-based editor that is nice to use when all you have is access to the terminal. Even today, some developers like to use Vim as their primary editor, the reason being that it is supposed to be faster since you don't have to move around your cursor with your mouse, and can instead use short key bindings built into Vim. For the next 30 days, I'm only going to use NeoVim, which is an extension of Vim, as my text editor.
Baby, on my hit list, I'm excited. Got me duplicate, it's a Friday.
If you don't want to see the 2-day process of configuring Vim, then skip to this time in the video. Okay, so day one, I just decided I'm going to start working on this C program. I had an idea for like this video processing thing. So I just start up a NeoVim process, start working on a main C program as well as like a make file. And then I start trying to jump between the files and I realize that's not working out so well. I have to close NeoVim before I can switch to the other file I want to edit. And I know that's not how you're supposed to use Vim. So I decide to just abandon the C project entirely. I'm just gonna kind of like get familiar with the configuration files and use that as my like testing grounds for learning the commands to jump between files and jump around directories with them. Once I started editing the config, I started installing plugins. Some of the plugins I installed were like a better directory browser for viewing files, some nice like syntax sugar stuff. You know, some stuff that's kind of built into VS Code. I really wanted to make sure that was there, that way I wasn't scared and felt too uncomfortable using NeoVim in the future. By the end of the day, I just decided I was gonna work on this tomorrow because I landed on this programming language called Lua, and people were writing their configs in that, and I had not been writing mine in Lua. I'd been writing it in like the default Vim file. So I decided, you know what, tomorrow I'm just gonna start over from scratch, write this all in Lua, and that's where I called it a day. So to start day two, I just kind of browsed some plugins. I looked at some references to see how other people set up their NeoVim. And then I just kind of jumped straight into the Lua stuff. I had to kind of learn Lua because I've never used it before. And it's basically just like a really weird scripting language. But I basically just took all the Vim stuff I had configured before, translated that in a sense to Lua. And that alone took a couple of hours. But then it was time to start, you know, really customizing NeoVim. So we're talking about customization, right? So that means, of course, I'm going to be talking about trying to set up a custom theme. I first tried to import and use this one called Monokai, which is my favorite, and I've been using it for VS Code for the longest time. However, I had really bad luck with that and found another one called, I think it's One Half Dark. And I just decided to go with that because I thought it looked pretty cool. Turns out that the terminal that's built into macOS has like limited colors, so I had to download another terminal emulator, iTerm, so that I could really get the full colors that are needed for the color scheme to work. Once I got the color scheme all set up, I started working on more useful plugins like getting Markdown support, as well as finally figuring out how to get like a sidebar so that it almost looks like an actual text editor. Probably spent an hour or so doing that, but in the end, it started looking like this. I then ended my day by editing my ZSH config and really just using Vim as an editor rather than just trying to configure it as I managed some ZSH stuff. At this point, I was already feeling pretty comfortable jumping between files, and especially comfortable like opening and closing files from the sidebar. Okay, so it's been 7 days since making the treacherous switch to Vim, and honestly, it hasn't been too difficult. Now, that does come with some exceptions, mostly being the fact that I feel like I spend like 50% of my time trying to reconfigure Vim every time I use it. Either that or just having to stop and look up how to do something, like, for example, searching for words is not as simple as, you know, pressing Control or Command F and then typing the word. You gotta hit the forward slash key, which is a little backwards if you ask me, but I think this is one of those things that comes with learning a terminal based editor instead of, you know, a shiny application like VS Code. For the most part, this last week has been great. Only exception in being that there are a couple features that I still want to implement, and that is changing the configuration so that I can figure out how to get multi-cursor to work, because that's one of my favorite features of VS Code, as well as commenting out code and getting the autocomplete and suggestions to work properly, because they're still a little bit finicky. Other than having to tinker around with the configuration a little bit, I think my biggest challenge is still getting those key bindings and navigating through files using the proper like Vim key bindings and mappings. One last thing I want to include for today is that I find myself defaulting to use the arrow keys to navigate through things, through the files, and I want to stop doing that, so I might just disable using arrow keys in Vim, because I need to get used to using those H, J, K, and L keys to navigate Vim the way you're supposed to. All right, so now we're 2 weeks in and things are a little frustrating, especially at the beginning of the week when I disabled the arrow keys. I was having a hard time navigating through files because, you know, I kind of default to use those arrow keys. And so I use this like Vim plugin that just disables them. And when you press the arrow keys, it kind of freezes everything. So by defaulting to that, I was kind of like stopping myself and honestly just slowing myself down from programming. But as the days went on, I think that I kind of got used to it. I just kind of, my hand stays away from the bottom right corner of the keyboard. Otherwise, everything has been mostly smooth sailing this last week. For week 3, I'm going to try and start using tabs, because I've just kind of been avoiding them up until this point. Should be a nice way to switch between files instead of having to use split windows. Alright, so it's been a month. I didn't record anything for week 3 because I didn't have any extreme feelings at that time. Yeah, for the most part, I feel pretty good. I do feel like this month has been kind of a bad time to make this switch because I haven't been doing like insane software development. You know, I haven't been working on massive projects where I need to jump between large directory structures or anything like that. But what I have done with, I feel like I really get around files a lot quicker. I don't, you know, try to use those arrow keys anymore like I was just 2 weeks ago. All right, so at this point, I understand why people say that Vim is faster. Although I'm probably not faster with Vim than I am with VS Code, I think that I probably will be here pretty soon. There's only a couple things that I still have yet to like truly figure out. One of those things is multi-cursor. There's kind of a way that you can get around that. If you're at like the start of a line, you can go into like visual block mode and kind of do like an insert and then repeat that insert onto those other lines that you selected in visual block mode. But that doesn't really work though when you're trying to do something a little more advanced where you're not at the exact same character on lines below and whatnot. But otherwise, it's been pretty smooth. I'm definitely gonna keep using Vim as my primary editor. I'll probably still rely on VS Code when it comes to like pair programming. That's mostly just because of plugins for VS Code like LiveShare, which is pretty much just like Google Docs, but for coding. I know that there's like ways to do that with Vim, but that would require the other person that I'm pairing with to also use Vim, and that's just not likely. So if you're thinking about making the switch to Vim, then I would highly recommend it. I'd suggest using a tool like NeoVim so you can have a little more customization and get those plugins installed and configured a lot easier. If you're hesitant to make this jump, then you can always install plugins for VS Code where you can use key mappings and move around files the same way you would with Vim. With that, you're not giving up those nice, comfortable things, such as multi-cursor, that you have with VS Code. You're just getting the really good part of Vim added to your environment. I'm going to leave a bunch of links in the description for all these resources that I mentioned, as well as a bunch of videos and things that helped me along the way as I made the transition. Make sure to hit that subscribe button if you want to see more content like this. I used to feel so devastated.